Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much once again to come here to Monday night, the Gate of Shuas, Shar Bitachon, Chovat Alvavot. In our opinion here in the BJCC, Bukhari and Jewish Community Center, third floor, a place to be, a place that inspires mind and soul, a place that changed millions of people, a place that getting everybody happy and closer to the Almighty God. Ladies and gentlemen, today the topic is Emunah v'bitachon, like usual, but above that is what exactly we need to do in order to be happy. In order to be happy, simcha, we all drive in our life to achieve one item, being happy. And not always smiling is meaning that you're happy. Because I don't know, somebody told me, Rabbi, it was a research that they made. The saddest people in the world, they are the clowns. You know, a clown that's always going out and smiling and is getting paid for it and he's jumping and making jokes, and the comedians that all day long making jokes happen to be that they made research coin and they found out that the most sad people, the sadness, the most people that take pills against depression is the comedian, the one that makes jokes all day long. And you look at them and how many times you told the, you know, if you know a guy that is a funny guy, who you know how to make a joke, how many times you told his wife, what a lucky woman you are? Most likely all day long is a joke. And you don't understand that this guy is about to jump. He knows how to make other people laugh. So laughing is not necessary being happy. So today we're going to touch maybe three advice how exactly we can achieve happiness. Very, very important and beautiful class. With Hashem help, with Yetzer Hara. Chacham Yaakov, the first one is, we mention it now, we just one day after Hanukkah. And Hanukkah, we said Hanukkah Sameach. Afreil lecha Hanukkah. Why Hanukkah Sameach? Because, and maybe this is connected, you know, I'm just coming out of my mind. You know why Hanukkah Sameach? Because in the word Sameach, they have the three mitzvot nadir that the Greek people try to take away from us. Which the three mitzvot the Greek went against? Ballistic. Shabbat, Mila, and Chodesh. The word Sameach. Shin, Shabbat, Mem, Mila, Chet, Chodesh. Why these three mitzvot? Why these three mitzvot? Why not Tefillin? Why not Kashrut? Why not Tzitzit? Why not Shatnez? Why these three mitzvot? What is so unique above all the other mitzvot? Maybe the answer is that we said, it's not only that we are different. In these three mitzvot above all, we're proving that we're different because Goyim also keep Shabbat. Christianity Sunday, they have Sunday in a different way, but they have like Sabbath, they call, I don't know, Sabbaton. They have Sunday, and Arabs have Friday. Mm-hmm. And bother, 100%. And bother the Greek, why we choose different day? Why you cannot be like us? Why you cannot, why you have to be unique? Why you cannot be Am Kechol Goyim? Too many Goyims in the history bother the same questions. I mean, I don't want to get into politics, but even when they built the Jewish land in 47, and their view and mine was to make it, don't be unique. Be like all the Goyim. It never helped us. It's not that the Goy will like you. Fact is, you know, 2 weeks ago, America, the best Eli in the world, the president decides to surprise all of us and to make the Western Wall a place that's considered to be a settlement. Doesn't belong to us. Are you joking? The Western Wall, Kotel HaMaravi, doesn't belong to us. Yerushalayim doesn't belong to us. But this is what we're dealing. No matter what you're going to do, you can go with Levi's, with the jeans Levi's all day long. You will never become one of them. You're always going to become a stranger and you're always going to be a Jew. So, bother them, why we have to be different? Okay. Mila, they also do Brit Mila. The Muslims also do Brit Mila. But we are the only ones that do in 8 days. Chodesh, they also have a calendar. Christianity follow the sun, Muslims follow the moon. We follow the sun and the moon. Why you have to be? Okay, follow the sun and the moon. Beautiful. Only the moon. We, every 3 months, we add month, right? You see, in the Muslim heritage, the Ramadan doesn't fall down always at the same time. Sometime in the winter, sometime in the summer. Why? Because they follow only the sun. We follow the sun, but once in 3 months, at the moon, once in 3 months, we add a month to make it correct. This way, our holidays always stand still. So the word Samech, Chanukah Samech, what is the message to our life? And you know what's the message? I said, in Chanukah, the reason that we light Chanukiah with olive oil, with oil, dafka, not with candles. If you see the mitzvah, the main mitzvah is to light the menorah, the Chanukiah, with olive oil. Why olive oil? A, because the miracle happened with olive oil. It's the original miracle. So to remind the original miracle, but this is simple. You're not coming here to the BJCC Yud Minyan Tot Flow to hear the simple. You're coming here to hear the death. And maybe the deeper explanation is, oil is symbol as what we're trying to say. Oil is the only items that never mixed and anything else. You put water, oil is always above and never mixed. You put wine, oil is always above and never mixed. You put alcohol, black label, blue label, gold label, never mixed. It's always good. Oil doesn't mix in anything. Maybe to tell you that to be Sameach in life, and just come right now in my mind. Go and listen to how deep is that. You know why comedians, they are not happy? Because all what they're doing is to please other. If all you've been is to please somebody else, and you don't have identity by your own, you will never be happy. You hear that? You see? You hear? Cohen? If all what you're doing is just to please other, even though that you're a great guy, maybe you're a great guy, maybe you're a funny guy, maybe people love you and admire you, it's amazing. But Netanel, we have to have our own identity. You don't have to bend over in order to make the whole world happy in any decision that you make. Being a rabbi, I know it. Not every decision that you make being a leader is a decision that has to be followed by people and have to agree, this is what we call leader. This is what we call a happy man. What makes us unique, the Jews, is that we are like olive oil. We have identity and we never mixed. Chanukah Sameach, Shin Shabbat, Mem Milah, Chet Chodesh, 3 mitzvot that define us to be unique. No, we have identity. So the secret to be happy, the first one is very simple. Remember that you are unique and you have identity. You don't have to scream, you don't have to shout, you don't have even to argue, but you don't have to change you. Don't change yourself. You're going to change yourself, you're going to lose yourself. So maybe other is going to be happy, but you're the only one that's not going to be happy. A comedian, his job is to change himself according to the people. Every night, he's like a snake. He's moving here and moving here. He bends over all over. But he's the only one that suffers. Afar va'efer tuchal kolim echecha. The snake is the only one that have no taste. You know why? He's bending over all day long. He just maneuvers himself in between. You have to have identity. To be happy, you have to create. One. Second explanation of happiness. Second advice is, you see, the Gemara, Masechet Ketubot said, Samech Zayin, 2 stories. 2 very similar stories, but different ending. It was one poor man that came in to Rav Nechamia. Rav Nechamia was a rabbi in that time. And he needed food. And he said, what do you want me to give you? He said, I want to get chicken, that are no fancy, good meat, and old wine. Yain Yashan. So Rav Nechamia said, I'm sorry. All what I have to be megalgel, the adashim. Terce legalgel iti ktsat adashim? How do you say adashim in English? Barley? Barley? Whatever, adashim. What the orphan people eat. When somebody loses his father,
lentils.
Beautiful. Have some lentils. Do you want to eat with me some lentils? The guy said, okay, I have no choice. Let's eat. He ate the lentils. But because he got used to the good life, the meat, the fancy meat, and the good wine, he died. And Chazal blamed this poor man for being dead. Oy leze sharagon nechamim. What a foolish man this guy. Right away, the Gemara gave another story. It was another poor man that came to Rava. And he came to Rava and said, Rava, I need to eat. He said, what do you want to eat? He said, אני רוצה לאכול עוף, תרנגולת מפותמת, fancy chicken, ויין ישן, old wine. So the rabbis looked at him and said, do you don't think that you are מטריח the ציבור? With such an attitude, with such a request, what, we have to give you fancy wine or fancy chicken? Maybe you want steak and kebab? Whatever I give you, how many times poor people came to us? So listen, I want from you $5. Or $10. Or $50. How many times Abraham come to you, somebody, you give me $1 and you look at you, chutzpan. Right away, what pass you, man? Ani chutzpan, that's a chutzpan. Said, thank you, right, Mordechai. The guy come to you and he have an attitude. I want $50 from you. This guy came to Rabbi and said, I want fancy food and fancy wine. And the Rabbi said, you don't think that you're pushing a little? שאתה מטריח את הציבור? אמר לו אותו אני, וכי משלך אני אוכל? What, you are the one that give me the food? The Almighty God give me the food. He said, how do you know? The pasuk said, עיני כל אליך יסברו, ואתה נותן להם את אוכלם ביתו. You're giving each one of them individual his own food. So you don't give me anything, no more. I'm not asking from you, I'm asking from him. A minute later, the sister of Rava was walking in with old wine ותרנגולת מפותמת and a good chicken. And Rava got the message, he gave it to the poor man. And my question to you, what is the difference between the first poor man to the second poor man? Why the first one die and the sages blame him and the second one got the good food? Nadir, can you give me the explanation? What's the difference? How do you know that the first one was not Ma'amin? He also asked the same. How do you know that he was not Ma'amin? Beautiful, I agree with you, but how do you know? What is the proof that the first one was not such a great Ma'amin? He ate what? Beautiful. He compromised very fast. You know, you come to ask for steak, and right away after you eat lentils, your emunah is not strong. If you really believe that God will give you what you want, why you compromise so fast? Mm-hmm. Remind me a story with Rabbi Israel Misalant. I believe Rabbi Israel Misalant one time came and said, ladies and gentlemen, anyone that will believe in Hashem Yitbarach to give him the best shidduch, the best children, or the best, and that time he offered money. He said, anyone that will believe in Hashem Yitbarach this week is going to believe, is going to win the lottery. And that week, 4 days later, it was supposed to be the lottery, $200 million. Now it was a poor man that came and said, you know, I mean, anyway, if I'm going to work the whole year, for the next 10 years, I'm not going to make $1 million. $20 million and the rabbi gave me 4 days? What's the... Rabbi, ani ma'amin be'emunah shelema, I believe in God. What did I need to do? So the rabbi said, all what you have to do is to read Tehillim, study you cannot, you're a simple man, to read Tehillim all day long. And if you have a strong faith, God will give you everything that you wish. Listen to this. Eli, the guy was reading Tehillim 1 day, 2 days. After 2 days, he almost fainted. He never read Tehillim so many times. For 12 hours, 15 hours, he's reading Tehillim. The rabbi came to him and he see him, so tired. He said, Moshele, how much I promise you? He said, Rabbi, you promised 200 million, we have in the lottery, 200 million. So the rabbi said, you know what, between you and me, I want to change my mind. Tell me, instead of 200 million, if I will give you right now cash, 5 million, you're going to give me the lottery ticket? He went and he bought lottery ticket. He said, for the rabbi, he's thinking, $5 million now is better for Muno. He said, rabbi, done deal. Take the ticket, give me the 5 million. The rabbi said, I'm sorry, you lost everything.
You wanted to give it to the rabbi?
No, if you believe so much, how can you give out so fast 195 million? Your faith is in shake. The second way to be happy, Abotech Bashem, Chesed Isovenu. You see, Abotech Bashem Chesed Isovenu It was a guy that left them. And they asked him one time, Sofer, Lo Alinu Velo Alechem, the Shari Bitachon, Rabbi Bechai Wright, he was once a Sofer. You know what Sofer? Sofer Stam, a person that read him, Sifre Torah and Mezuzot. So his friend asked him, how is your life? Meaning, how do you do Panasa wise? He said, as long that my hand is working, Baruch Hashem, it's all good. And that day, Lo Alinu Velo Alechem, his hand got cut off.
Oh.
Your hand is the one that gives you the Panasa? Or I am the one that gives you the Panasa? What do you mean, as long that my hand is good, it's all good? And if your hand is not good, it's not good? Hashem Yitbarach is the one that gave us the parnasa. All what we have to have is a faith in the Almighty Hashem. And this is what they said, Rabbanit Sirotkin. Listen to this. Rabbanit Sirotkin came in, and she went into the doctor. She had a surgery. She had an open heart surgery. Very righteous lady. She came to the doctor and listened to what she said to the doctor. Cohen, you're going to love it. She came to the doctor and she said, Natanen, she came to the doctor and said, dear doctor, I want to tell you, first of all, thank you very much for going the extra mile to do the surgery. I know that every brain surgery, every heart surgery is a very difficult surgery. And the risk and the sweat that you pass in, it was a very, very complicated surgery. So she said, first of all, thank you very much. And second, I'm telling you from now, that if the surgery is not going to work out, אני מוחלת לך. I forgive you. Don't feel bad if I'm going to die on the table of the surgery. You know, don't blame yourself. The doctor looked at her and said, he felt, wow, what a holy lady. Who is this? Who is the one that's telling? If anything, I'm going to sue you. I have my uncle, he's a lawyer. Don't worry. He's here. He have a camera just to make sure. If you're going to make mistakes, you're going to pay for it. This is usually what you hear. A person that before surgery is telling you, she said, if anything is going bad, don't blame yourself. You didn't do it. This is a Hashem plan. Maybe God doesn't want me to continue to be alive. So don't blame yourself. So he was so happy with that. And he was about to leave. And he said, doctor, I want to tell you another things. And if there's anything going good, I also want to remind you, don't take the credit. Hashem is the one that's doing it. Ah, yeah, yeah. He liked the first part. The second part he didn't like. If it's going good, it was not you. It's Hashem as well. So don't come and cup your hand. Ah, I'm a great doctor. Huh? What a brilliant. We like the first part of the story. I know that the first part, everybody is connected. But to the second part, the part to understand that Hashem is the one that doing everything in our life. I will conclude this part, this second part, by saying, Esapra and Chuk, it was a rabbi that once said, that if you, chuk is food. Chuk hakakti. The nature is to get food. If a person will come to a human being, David HaMelech said, listen to what David HaMelech, he's a rabbi that gave a beautiful explanation. It's a prayer chuki. When a person is going to come to you and say, Rabbi, where is Parnasa? Where is God? Why I don't have money? It's a prayer chuk. El chuki. I'm coming and I'm asking questions. Ve'Hashem amar elai. And God referred to this guy. The guy that complained all day long, Beni ata, my dear son, Ani ayom yeladeticha. Question mark. Ani ayom yeladeticha? You're complaining like until now, who give you the food? Who give you all the things that you have? I give it to you. So why are you complaining like I never prove myself? Who give you your life? I give you your life, and I sustain you until now, until the age of 20, totally, fully. So why you continue to complain about Parnas Avram? Beniata, you are my son. Ani ayom eladeticha, what I brought you yesterday to the world. You are already 20 years here. And Baruch Hashem, you have Parnas Avram, and you have children, and you sponsor all of them. So why you worry so much? If anything happened, it's Hashem. And if the credit in Parnassah is coming, it's also Hashem Yitbarach. Second way to be happy is to have a faith in the Almighty God. So we said the first one is identity, the second one is emunah. Number three. Number three, and for that we came tonight. Somebody sent me this class from Aravian. And it was a beautiful class, a beautiful, beautiful ideas. He said, the Zohar HaKadosh Haid, the Zohar HaKadosh Haid, how did the person know that you follow the footsteps of God? How do you know that what you're doing in Torah Mitzvot, this is the Emet? איך ידע האדם שהוא בדרך הנכונה? דוד המלך עסק בתהילים, מי יעלה בהר השם ומי יקום במקום קודשו? How do you know that you're going in the path of God? מודך, how do you know that? The Zohar HaKadosh asks the million dollar question. And tonight you're going to get the answer. How do you know that you follow the foot? Maybe it's only imagination. And ladies and gentlemen, we have many people that imagine their imagination, that they are mekubalim, tzadikim, that they worship God. No, here lecha elokim acherim. We can have many gods. Some of our gods is actually idols. We believe that we connect to Hashem, but we connect to literally idols. So how do you know that you follow Hashem Yitbarach Atzmo in the right path? Mi yaneh be'ar Hashem? Omer HaZohar, and you know that. To know this question is the most important questions to know. You know why? Because David HaMelech said, Ve'ani kirvat Elokim li tov. One of the best pasukim, people that know me know that this pasuk I love the most. Ve'ani kirvat Elokim li tov. When I'm close to Hashem, it's all good. Nothing is more important from being close to the Almighty God. Now, I know that nature-wise, we're thirsty. We're thirsty for money. We're thirsty. Our neshama is always screaming, more and more and more money. We're thirsty for kavod, respect, being recognized. We're thirsty for temptation, animal temptation. We're thirsty for food. But I will tell you what's the common denominator among all of them. Not the food, not the animal needs, not the money, and not the kavod. We never satisfied our thirst. You know why? Hoy kol tzame lechu lemaim, ve'en maim ela Torah. Because our thirst is not a physical thirst. We're thinking that this is physical. You know what is our thirst called? Our thirst is our neshama, that screaming, give me to drink. I need something to feel satisfied. I need to feel good with myself. So what do we do in order? We're going to make money, we believe, it's good for 1 month, 2 months, 1 year, and that's it. We buy a new car, it's good for 1 week. We buy a new watch, it's good for a few days. We're trying to fill up the toast, it will never help. The only way to make sure that this toast is going to be is to follow the footsteps of God. Ve'ani kirvat Elokim litov. When I'm close to Hashem, Mrs. Bar, Mrs. Bar, ve'ani kirvat Elokim litov. She'adam karov l'Hashem et barach. She'adam karov l'Hashem. As התשובה היום זה בעצם התשובה הכי חשובה שיש. Our answer tonight is the most important answer. How do you know that you're close to Hashem? Let's read the Zohar HaKadosh, word by word. How did the Pasuk said in Mishlei? Anna alach dodech, venevakshenu imach. Where is my God, my beloved? Where is that? The Almighty God that I'm searching, venevakshenu, I want. Beshata debar nash, azal beurcha dekutsha berichu. When a person, when a human being follows the footsteps of God, this is Bishata, in the time, the Barnash, that a human being, Azal, walking, Beurcha, on the path, the Kutsha Berichu, the Almighty God, this is the Zohar, Kutsha Berichu Mekarvelei. God, when you follow the footsteps, when we follow the footsteps of God, Mordechai, God is getting close to us. And how do you know that God is going, that God is getting closer to you? God will give you a gift. That only if you're close to Him, you have it. Only, and if you don't have it, meaning you're not close to Him. Very simple. Only if you're close, you're going to have it. And if you're not close, you're not going to have it. Wow. I hope that you're not going to be upset after I'm going, what I'm going to tell you. Because this gift is very unique. And how, the Zohar Kadosh? And how did the person know that? V'yahiv nalei shalva v'naicha. God will give him peace of mind. V'naicha meaning menucha. Rest. If you see a person that is rest, and he have peace of mind, and nothing can get him upset, and he doesn't get mad and shouting, and he doesn't go depressed because his wife make him a sour face and all day long, because, why bad things happen to good people? My wife is upset with me. No, nothing get him upset. Nothing move him from his own mood. It's always in a good mood. Shalva v'naicha. Shalva v'menucha. Do you know how you know that you're in the footsteps of God? When God is getting closer to you. And how do you know that God is getting closer to you? When you have peace of mind. Wow. Cohen, huh? Was worthy to come tonight, huh? We owe money to some people. I know I need to pay. Life is good. Baruch Hashem. Same smiling, the same relax. They fire me from the job, Baruch Hashem. You know? Same smiling, same, you know how difficult is that? It's easy in a speech. I will tell you how far, in a second I will tell you how far we're going to go with that. How did the Chazal said regarding to Yosef HaTzadik? And this is how do you know that Yosef HaTzadik was in the footsteps of God? Listen to this word of Chazal. Who Yosef Bevet HaAsurim? Who Yosef Bebet HaMalchut? Who Yosef Bebet Aviv? The same Yosef that was in the house of his father was the same Yosef that was in the jail, was the same Yosef when he was in the house of the king. Meaning, he never changed. Shalva u'menucha. And the jail, you see him smiling. Well, why are you smiling? Is anything, maybe you need psychology, maybe you need... Nothing, it's all good, Baruch Hashem. Hashem Yitbarach is running the world. When something good happens, don't take the credit. When something bad will happen, don't blame yourself. Somebody is running the world. You remember the Rabbanit? She told them, if you're going to fall down, don't blame yourself. It's Hashem Yitbarach is running the world. But if you're going to succeed, Yosef achieved, he fell down. He didn't blame himself right away. I want to jump, maybe here, nothing. Smiling. I don't know what I'm doing here, but most likely Hashem have a plan for me. I don't know what's the plan, but it's the plan of God. So he was relaxed for 12 years in the jail. Arabic jail. Hamas, Hezbollah, Fatah, Imach Shemam V'Shem Zichram, ISIS, Shmaisis, all of them. And this guy is the most beautiful human being in the world history. A Jew, above all, with kippah. Not baseball, not the Yankees, monkeys. No, not Yankees. He went with kippah, nice kippah. Rishon Lezion. Most likely he was Sephardi. The big kippah, the Rishon Lezion in the Glima. He's coming to them. Kvod Harav, everybody kisses him. And he's relaxed and smiling. Nachat Ruach. Nadir, what a shiur, huh? What a shiur.
So that's how you know that you're in the right path.
I told you, I don't want you to lose it. This is once in a week, that's it. The secret of Torah. Who Yosef HaTzadik? How do you know that you're close to Hashem? When Hashem is getting close to you. And how do you know that Hashem is close to you? When He give you the gift, what's the gift? Peace and rest. If shalva or menucha. If you don't get upset and boiling like a fire, you know you're on a good path. You can do all the mitzvot, all the shasen. Listen to what the Saba Mekanim writes. Shezehu shlemut ha'adam. If you want to know what is your achievement in life, how do you know that you achieve a perfect level? Some people will tell you, Eli, finishing a perfect mission is finishing the whole shas, finishing the Shulchan Aruch, finishing the whatever, Kabbalah, Zohar. And I tell you, they're all beautiful, but they're all wrong. Shlemut ha'adam is when a human being got in to shalva u'menucha. Not when he's dead, when he's alive. When he's dead, definitely shalva u'menucha. When he's alive. But he becomes so protected. that nothing really, nothing really can bother him. Mohai v'rabotai. Wow. Shalva u'menucha. Wow. And this was the pasuk, and this for Chacham Yaakov. Because Chacham Yaakov loved Tehillim. Shuvi nafshi lemenuchaych. Go back to your menucha. Go back to your peace of mind. And you know why? Ki Hashem gamal alaychi. Now when you're going to read it, you understand the meaning. Until now, nemachachi, shumayachi, nobody understands. Shuvi nafshi lemenuchaychi. Go back because this, and you know why? Ki Hashem gamal alaychi. The Almighty God is running the world. So you can be relaxed. Relax, enjoy the time. Hashem is running the world. Ashir al Hashem, ki gamal alay. How did the pasuk said? Gam ki elech begeitz al mavet, lo ira. Even if I'm going to go in the shadow of death, I will never be afraid. I will never be frightened. Why? Ki ata imadi, the Almighty God. Atai Madi, you are with me. Nothing is so greater for having Hashem in our life. For understanding. How did the Pasuk said, Chacham Yaakov, listen to this one? Lo berash Hashem. Lo beruach Hashem. Lo be'esh Hashem. Kol Hashem bedmama daka. You know, how do you know in which Hashem dwell? Not a person that is in a fire. Wow, tzagot. Lo beruach, not a person that's like a balloon. A balloon. Ash, fire. Rabbi, let's put everything in the fire. Gasoline, they put my pictures and they put the barbecue on the rabbi is in fire. The rabbi is in fire. Lo be'esh Hashem, lo beruach Hashem. Kiim. Kiim. Kol Hashem et mamadaka. And you see a person that always relax, always calm. You know that God is with them. Kol Hashem et mamadaka. Shalva u'menucha. Peace. Rest, rest. This is when you know that God is with you. Why? Ay, ay, ay. שזהו שלמות של העולם. Now, how do you know that שזה השלמות של העולם? How do you know that this is our purpose in life? When God created the world, what is the last thing that Hashem created? שהיה חסר לו לעולם מנוחה. לכן, בא שבת, בא... שבת symbolizes עולם הבא. And if it's anything that עולם הבא, symbolizes what? Shabbat menucha. Shabbat, we rest. We relax. We enjoy. We have shalva. We don't get fire. We don't scream. We don't shout. Everything is in relax. Wow. Lo be'esh Hashem. Ve'lo beruach Hashem. Ki'im be'kol demama daka. God is when a person in a quiet voice, when he is in a quiet, relax, then you know that Hashem is with them. Wow, wow. I'm talking to all of us here. If a person wants to be with Hashem Yitbarach, לכן חזר סייד שאדם נמדד בכעסו, כסו כסו וגם כעסו. Your anger management can prove if God is with you or not. When you get upset, when you get angry, you know that Hashem is not with you. Very simple. Because if you're going on the right path, you cannot get upset. Because the gift of going on the right path is what? Yahiv nalei, shalva o menucha. They give you the gift of having a peace of mind and rest. This is the gift. If you don't have that meaning, you're not yet close to Hashem. Because of that, our sages said, and by the way, we have no argument that Hashem is running the world. We saw it last year, twice. We saw it this year, here in America, when all the ad, when all the ad was against Donald Trump, when all the newsletter claimed that he's funny, and he's mukyon, and he's a joke, and he's here, and he's crazy. How many times you heard this word? And who is our president? Donald J. Trump. We saw it in Israel as well. Bibi Netanyahu. All the media was against him. They got millions and millions and millions of dollars to promote any ad against him. And who is the prime minister? So who is running the world? The media? The analyzed people? The analysts? They got so much money going, they get. Each one of them half $1 million. And you can, and if the, if one of them was honest, he's going to resume today. But none of them is honest. They are there only for the money. Nobody cares the fact that he made the mistakes. They continue like that, nothing happened. Nobody's honest to admit, I'm sorry, everything that we said is nonsense. And you know who's running the world, Hashem. But it's not their job. Their job is to make money. And all of them fell down. They went into Harvard, to Yale, and Cohen, you know how number is accurate. They made the best analysis. You cannot make mistakes. You cannot make mistakes. Zero mistakes. But they forgot one ad. The Almighty God. Hashem, Itbarach is the one that ran it. We know it. They don't know it. So if Hashem is running the world, why to get upset? Shalva u'menucha. This is Be'emet. Why to have pezizut? Sometimes you're driving in even to a synagogue and you want to make mincha, you want to make, and if not, you're getting upset, and I'm talking to all of us. You know how many times you want to make mincha and you get upset with your wife and you're finding, and this? It's better that you're going to pray a chid because this is the purpose of life. I'm not saying melekatchila, but if doing the mitzvah would cost you issue in shalom bayit, issue with anger management, you know what you're doing? You're pushing Hashem away. What do you do? I'm praying to you, but which Hashem is going to stand next to you? If the Zohar Kadosh writes that the only way to know that you are close to Hashem is by having shalva u'menucha, so if you don't have it, so meaning, you know what you're doing? You know what's funny? It's like you're calling, you're pushing away your father, and then you pray, please, Abba, give me. I mean, what give me? Last, I mean, a second before you just push me away. Being angry and upset. You know how we study it from the Torah? Who is the one that because he was zealous, he was fast, he had no menucha, no shalva, that lost everything good that he had. And he had a good attention. Pachas kamayim al tutar. Yechi Reuven ve'al yamut. Reuven was the first child of Yaakovinu. He did something that was pezizut. He didn't have menucha. He ran away to do the mitzvah. That he thought that it was a mitzvah. What's the reward that he got for it? He lost. He's not a Kohen. He's not a Levi. He's not Bechor. He's not king. He's not Talmid Chacham. And he's not rich. And I will explain. He's not king. Yehuda took away from Reuven. Reuven was supposed to be everything, by the way. The Ben HaBechor. So he's not king because Yehuda took it. He's not Bechor because Yosef took it. He's not rich because Zevulun took it. He's not Talmid Chacham because Yisachar. Yisachar is the one that took all the rabbis. Came from Yisachar. And he's not the Kohen because Levi took it. And why? Pachas Kamayim. Don't rush. Don't rush. Hi. Relax. Relax. Enjoy. Menuchat nefesh. Ah. And now that we know this class, we know that the only way to be happy and the only way to be successful is to have peace of mind. If our job all day long is to work in what? Of having a peace of mind. Because of that, when God wants to punish the Rasha'im, Mordechai, what did the Pasuk said? When God wants to punish the Rasha'im, En Shalom L'Rasha'im. I will never give a Rasha peace of mind. He's going to have money, he's going to have ladies, he's going to have children, he's going to have kavod, but Shalom is not going to have. That's very simple. And if you have Shalom, you have nothing. And if you don't have shalom, you have nothing. You can have everything you want, but then shalom. Shalom, man. Shalom is the essence. If you have shalom, you have nothing. If you don't have peace of mind, if you're not relaxed, nothing. And shalom l'rasheim v'mar Hashem. Ay, ay, ay. This is what Haman HaRasha say in Megillat Esther. What Haman HaRasha said? V'kol zeh einenu shaveh li. Haman HaRasha had ladies, he had children, beautiful children, he had money, he had kavod, he had anything. But ma, anything? Haman HaRasha actually was a very honest man, very smart man. One thing she was missing, that included everything, he had no shalom. Not peace of mind. He had no peace of mind. One person bothered him. I have nothing. We call the Eno Shaveri. I will conclude by saying this is the reason that the Gemara said Talmidei Chachamim en lahem menucha. If you say that menucha is the most important, so how the Gemara said Talmidei Chachamim en lahem menucha lo ba'olam hazeh ve lo ba'olam haba? Why Talmid Chacham doesn't have rest? If rest and peace is the most important. And maybe the explanation is that the test of Talmid Chacham, to know who is Talmid Chacham amiti, who is not, to know if Hashem is with you, who is not, is if you don't have a rest and to see how you react. If you pass in an obstacle and still react quiet, you know that God promised Abraham Avinu, Lech lecha me'artzecha, and I will make you rich, and I will give you children, and I will make you famous. A minute later, what the pasuk said? A minute later. Vayi ra'av ba'aretz, vayi radavah mitzayma. Avraham Avinu took him, maybe a year or few, to get into Israel. And God promised him, don't worry, I'm going to make you rich, I'm going to make you successful. He came to Israel, and what the pasuk said? There was no food. There was no food, he had no choice, what? To go out to Egypt. Anyone else will complain. Why bad things? Why I left my family? Why I put my father behind? You promised me Israel. Did you hear Abraham Avinu ever complain? Vayered Avraham Mitzrayma. Yes, it's no peace. God challenged them. But he does just want to see the way that you react. If you're going to react to the obstacle with Menucha v'Shalva, then you know that L'Olam Haba. You're not going to have menucha because you're going to get paid for all what you did here. Because Hashem was with you. This is what the Ben Ishchai write and coin. This is for you. The Ben Ishchai write, Cohen once told me that to define a human being, you have to check the way that he eat. The way that a man eats. If he's attacking the food or if he's enjoying the food. The Ben Ishchai write that when a person eats with menucha v'shalva, when a person eats slowly, עליו הפסוק אומר, אכול בשמחה לחמך, ושתה בטוב ליבך יינך, כי רצה השם אלוקים את מעשיך. If you eat with peace, with שלווה, with מנוחה, meaning that Hashem love you very much, that Hashem gave you the gift to be close to Him. Even in the way that you eat, Ulala, Cohen, we need to do the Shuvah. Even in the way that we eat, in the way that we speak, in the way that we talk. The way to achieve greatness and happiness in life is A, to remember to build yourself, identity. Identity meaning ishiyut, personality. Don't bend over. Don't make everybody else happy but yourself. Don't change yourself for no one. This is one. Second thing we spoke today is having a faith in Emunah. Don't compromise very fast. But last but not least is, remember, if you want to know that Hashem is with you, maybe the only tool, Shlemut HaAdam, to make yourself perfect is having peace and rest. Shalva u'menucha. May the Almighty God bless all of us and the millions of people that are watching on YouTube or on any other platform to have Shalva u'menucha. May God will bless all of us. I will bring Mashiach to the Kelim and Rabbi Aminu. V'chein yi ratzon v'nomar Amen.